Nah, it looks like it has a standard. Merciless extermination. I'm assuming that's just nightmare difficulty. But he has these labeled as the Doom 64 equivalents. That's pretty cool. Like how it doesn't even start you off with a pistol. This music I don't really recognize. Might be from Quake. Well, Quake 64. Got a chainsaw at least. Actually, let me see if... Not that I think dynamic light settings even matter here. Yeah, everything's on as it should be. Actually, yeah. Keep Doom on just in case it gets too dark. And you know what? List maps. I just want to see how many are actually in here. There's only six. There's only seven maps. One's a secret map. But 237 enemies, but each map's probably really long. Who knows, this could end up bleeding into, Monday. He didn't disable jumping and crouching, but I have a feeling it's... I won't use it unless I think it's required. I just noticed there was mega armor up here. We'll probably get that later. So I did also play the first one on like a few months back, I played the first Threshold of Pain of this. It seemed pretty standard, and I actually didn't think it used the PlayStation sound effects, even though it was... It very much fit the theme, so it's kind of glad that this one does use it. That didn't open up anything in here. Wait, I heard something. It opened up something in there, but I can't go in there yet. I think it did anyway. Oh! Okay. So I think that was the secret that I opened up. Wait, what the? Oh, he... God! I didn't see him come down the stairs. It looked like he just appeared right in front of me. Okay, didn't expect that. Yeah, when I tested this, I didn't get this far. I did a very, very quick play test of this. And that was like months back. That was around the time where I was like considering playing the others. Oh yeah, we do have a yellow key now. Which for some reason is not appearing in the top right. Oh, that wouldn't have been when it kept going up and down. Nah, it's not a secret. Not a secret. Mm. I definitely like the blue lighting in this hallway. The fuck? Surprised that hit me. Alright. Now might be a good time to actually make a save. Threshold of Pain 2. Top 2. Yeah, and that's why I saved. Giving us plenty of ammo now. Wait. There's something good up there. Actually kind of sounded like it opened something in here, but I'm not sure. There we go. And that's why I saved. Jesus Christ. Actually, shit, I probably should have looked up if jumping's allowed. I kind of have a feeling it is. Hang on. I think I have the, I have the readme extracted. Consists of 7 maps, 6 plus 1 secret. New sounds, new music, new graphics, other. Doesn't say if it's allowed. Does not, unfortunately, say if jumping is permitted or not. It seems like it is because of how he has some of this set up. New elements included. Midway's inspired design app. Wow, this is old, and I don't think he released anything other than this, so he must have stopped working on it. Yeah, it doesn't say whether jumping and crouching are allowed. That's a shame. Finally found some armor. I think jumping and crouching are allowed. Yeah, I'm almost certain it is. Because there was no way I could get through there. I would have been stuck. Okay, so we established that it's allowed, probably required. So now it's no holds barred. I think that's the only way that you can actually get some of the stuff up here. Oh, there's a red key. Forget if jumping and crouching were allowed in the previous one. That might also mean that the Berserk pack in the Mega Armor previously. I may have to get them via jumping. Let's go back for that, actually. There we go. Oh, I can... Oh. Shortcut. Well, I get blasted in the face almost immediately. Very uncomfortable position. There we go. Oh! Weird, I thought I was here already. He gave the Hell Knights green blood. He also added Shadow Imps. Nice, nice. I like it. Well, Nightmare Imps. Same difference. Ooh, actually there might be a secret in there. Not right there. It's in... this. Yep. There's one more secret that I did not get. Not exactly sure where to be, though. Yeah, surprisingly enough, the secrets... I wouldn't necessarily say they're too easy to find. Or too obvious. I'd say they're actually pretty standard. That secret might be in that last room. Thank you. Cool, even like underwater segments. Alright, that ends the level. I actually kind of want to find the last secret, since I know there's a secret level. It doesn't seem like there's anything out of the ordinary out here, so it's probably something I missed earlier in the level. Actually a nice find. Yeah, didn't think it'd be up here. This is symmetrical anyway. There's like an area that I didn't discover. That, like, has no secrets in it. I'd say that bottom area, probably. That's the thing, though. I don't see anything out of the ordinary here. I wonder. Maybe the last secret's in there. It's just a matter of getting up there, though. This is gonna be a hard one to get, because I have to strafe run it. I'm almost thinking that this is probably not a secret, and I'm probably gonna get stuck down there. No, it's a secret. That's the final secret, too. Cool. Alright, time to go. That one was actually pretty well hidden. Let's see, I got the shotgun down there, right? Yep. Or the shotgun shells, I mean. I think that's 310, yeah, so. There may only be 7 maps, but each one of them is pretty long. This could very well take 2 stream sessions. Okay, so can't go in there yet. I do very much like that he took jumping and crouching into the equation. Mainly because it seems like most Doom mods just don't take the idea that you can take verticality into effect, or into mind when designing your maps. Most just like the stick. Not even most. The majority, I think, yeah. A lot like sticking with vanilla, the vanilla concept. But I actually kind of prefer when people get creative with what they have. I don't need that yet. And can kind of bend the rules a little. So it kind of changes up the formula. Came from behind me. The specters, and I guess they're the nightmare specters. I just saved, so let's try it. Oh, okay. All right. Soul Sphere and a rocket launcher. Thank you. Damn, he was quick on that. I almost blew myself off. God, I was close. Oh, I missed. Find the super shotgun. I found the rocket launcher before I found the super shotgun. Oh god, my glasses. God, I actually didn't know where that came from. Oh. Oh, we still have plenty of this level to go. Oh. Well, not that I really need this right now. It's actually not dark enough for me to really need this. There's that blue armor over there, but can't really reach it from here. Another thing too, I don't have a rad suit. Don't really want to go down there. So what did that do? I actually thought it would drain this. But that doesn't seem to be the case. Wait. Oh, it lowered this. Okay. Thank you. Alright, that lowered that. Don't have a blue key yet. Hey, Karu. Yep. This is actually part of the map pack that I'm playing. It's not the sound pack that I'm using. It's, this map pack is actually more, Doom 64 inspired. Despite using the vanilla. See, we got Nightmare Imps. Yeah, this is a little more open. Which is fine. Nothing wrong with that. I don't know, this music's not from Doom 64 though. This is either from PlayStation Doom or this is Quake 64. I think it's PlayStation Doom. So it's kind of like a mix of both. Damn. Shotgunning in unison. You also have some unique enemies, like those chainsaw zombies. Basically got rid of the pinkies for me. You know what? This mod kind of does it in a way, like at least on a part of the first map. Like another way to like institute the idea of whether or not there's jumping or crouching allowed is to introduce something that requires you to jump, like actual progression in the level, or crouch. Just to signify that you're supposed to be using it. mean, putting it in the readme file also helps, but he didn't put it in this, but there was one point where I needed to crouch, so. And also all of those items that he put around the area that I couldn't get to otherwise. So that was sort of the signal that they're both allowed. Field boss? Jesus Christ. Fuck you. That actually made me jump back. Holy shit. That spider sprite, I think that's from Blood. That's either from Blood or it's modified from Blood. That doesn't seem like it's fully from Blood. I don't know if that's the only spider. Oh god. His aggro sound effect was also loud as fuck, so that's why it scared the shit out of me. So good jump scare. That one was actually effective. Oh! Finally got the double barrel. Well, a super shotgun. It's really hard not to call it the double barrel. I missed again. Oh, them. Well, I'm dead. Thank you. That's put me in a really bad position. Hey, Bone. Oh, I wonder. There might be, like, some goodies back here. I think they're modified from the spiders from Blood, but, I think they're kind of made to look like the spiders from Doom 3. But yeah, I am not in good shape right now. Is there any healing in here that I may not have picked up? Yeah, there is. I want to kind of go back and try and figure out how to get that. But I have a feeling I need a rad suit in order to even get that mega armor I saw. And with the amount of health that I have, it might not be worth it still. Yeah, I'm not gonna go back for it. We do have the key for that, but I have to actually hit a switch in order to open that. We need to go this way. Oh. I don't know what that was that I just picked up. Shit, I ran out of ammo. Oh good, please start infighting. In fact, now I don't even need to bother with you guys. Alright, and I know what that just opened. Not here, it's north. Oh! I didn't even realize this was a secret. Good, I kind of needed the extra ammo. Oh, that's why I had 5 rockets, too, because I picked up another backpack earlier. That was the beginning of the level. Oh. I Good, I needed that. I went backwards. Yeah, we can't go in there yet. This is where we need to go. Hello. That's a grenade launcher. Hey, Asmati. I stream often. A little scary. I have a rocket launcher already. I'm not quite sure the grenade launcher is worth it. It's not the best looking. I think I've seen it in other mods before, though, but maybe in a different variation. Oh, good, they died too. Oh, yeah. I think that is where I recognize it. It didn't look this brown before, though. Oh, wait. But there. Yeah, there is something there. Doesn't look like there's anything in here. Oh, shit. Well. Now I'm picking that up. Oh, hi. I almost didn't see them. Yeah, I have the yellow key now. Oh, hi. Oh, that's how I got the super shotgun, because they're super shotgunners. I don't think the secret level's on this level. I hope not. Eh, worst comes to worst, I'll just teleport, or I'll just, put in the code and pistol start on it. Oh yeah, definitely. Alright, on map 3. About as big as the last one was. Alright. Thank you. Running really low on shotgun ammo. Hi. Hey, prayers have been answered. Of course. It's also great that they not only announced Doom 64 re-release, but you get it as a pre-order bonus. Actually kind of like that. I would have bought it regardless. I'm still waiting to put in my pre-order because there's not really any reason to put it in right away. Not for a digital copy. Well, that's true. A lot of people who may not be Doom enthusiasts that would know how to even be able to get run or don't really care to, that's the easiest way for them to actually be able to play it. Shit, this is good. I did not even hear him. Perfect. I didn't get that far anyway. Yeah, I've kind of dedicated my stream to it, so I've been ending up, I've ended up playing a lot of them. There's still a lot, especially more well-known ones that I still haven't gotten to yet. Damn it. What the fuck? Oh. Where the hell was he? He was just following me that entire time. Full-on slaughter maps, especially, like, the ones that are specifically designed to be slaughter wads. I don't touch those too often. Ones that kind of have slaughter maps interspersed between them, like certain mega wads, like Ancient Aliens kind of does that. Those ones are the only ones that I've done. There is one that I plan to get to called Slaughter Spectrum, done by Bridgeburner, that I actually want to play because I really like his map design. But that's far down on my list at the moment. This isn't good because my health is only at 23. It is good. It's punishing. It's one of the harder ones. But it's very colorful and still very well done. I didn't take to it too much because that was actually one of the first major mega wads that had slaughter maps interspersed between it, so I didn't like it at first. But like on thinking back on it though, it was better than what I gave it credit for. I played it on Ultra Violence too, so that also tells you something. They have Zombie Man rocket launchers. Feel like trying that again. Oh god. My mates sneeze. Oh! Excuse me. Oh yeah, you looked at the... I actually forget, did I update that? I think I did. That might not actually be my current PC build. Nah, it's the right one. Alright. The headset and... The headset's not right, though. Forgot to update that. The headset's an Audio-Technica. It didn't click until, like, the last minute. There was another rocketer. Now I gotta do this part over a third time. Where did he even come from? Oh, he was behind that. Okay. Yeah, I actually used to... I used to be AMD because they were cheaper, and they're actually still pretty good. I switched to NVIDIA because at the time, like during their 900 series, before like AMD ever released their Ryzen series, Nvidia was always considered better. But AMD was still good because it was not only the cheaper option, like, most games, like, you could run them in pretty decent settings with, like, the most recent version of it. I actually used to do Crossfire, too. That was, like, 2 PC builds ago. That was completely random. I just decided to check that, because why not? I save, just in case. But I wouldn't be against going back to AMD if I ever wanted to do another build. The only thing about AMD that I don't like, their GPUs always run hotter. I think that's still true, as far as I know. You need extra cooling to compensate for that. I do kind of like Nvidia now. I'm not sure if I would, if I do another PC build, I'd switch, but I wouldn't be against it. I'd compare the two and see what I get. No rocketers. Now I'm paranoid. I'm afraid he's gonna stick one of those rocket men, like, right around the corner, like this guy. Because they look like them. They're the only thing that's different about them is their face. Like him. It didn't register until right before I actually hit him that that was the rocket guy. I know he was gonna pull that shit. It does fire faster. It does have that going for it. Oh. Nice. They're like that in any mod that I see them in, too. Fortunately for this mod, it seems like he just uses them he intersperses them throughout the level. Small doses, they're fine. When did I open this? Also, what is this? Whatever it is, I can't get it. I think it's just decoration. I was a super shock on it, Jesus. Doom Sphere? Maybe this is double damage. Yeah, this is double damage. It scares them? Doesn't seem to be scaring them. Ooh. I wonder how I get that. Got hit by everything. They move slower, but they spit slime at you. Uh-oh. How far back did that put me? That didn't put me that far back. It was right before I got the secret. Hey, little Paradox. I didn't go this way yet. Oh yeah, by the way, in case no one noticed, since there's a decent amount of people here right now. Hit the 500 follower milestone. So that means, I think I'll probably do it Monday. If this runs over into Monday, then I'll do it immediately after. That means that I'm gonna do a run through of the entire Doom series with the Meta Doom mod. Hey, subs. So that means it's another run through of Ultimate Doom, Sigil, Doom 2, Master Levels, Final Doom, meaning TNT, Plutonium Experiment, No Rest for the Living, and Doom 64 for Doom 2, because that's the only way that I can use different mods with it. I think the next one, I'm either going to do Beautiful Doom or just Vanilla Doom. Like, vanilla meaning I turn mouse look off. If it's Vanilla Doom, then I'd probably do another run of Doom 64 Retribution, because... Or, not Vanilla Doom, Beautiful Doom. Because that's essentially... kind of the same thing. I know I didn't do that with Brutal Doom. Like, I know there's a Brutal Doom 64, but that's a different story. This is not where I'm supposed to be going. But I used... Again, I used Doom 64 for Doom 2, because that's the only one that I can use weapon mods with. Any other version of Doom 64 isn't really... mod-friendly. And even that one's kind of not mod-friendly because it has custom monsters. Namely, it adds these guys. And, the Mother Demon. I got turned around, so where was that area that I was in last time? Wait, was it down here? I think there's a door down here, but... Oh, wait. Oh! Yeah, this is where I got killed. I think, anyway. Don't have a yellow key yet. And so I'll need to come back here. Yeah, again, I won't be streaming tomorrow, because, I'm going with my friends to a movie. And I don't stream on Saturdays or Sundays. I can't go in there yet. Or there. That wasn't the area that I was thinking of. Was there a switch I had to hit in here? Maybe I missed it. Yeah, I think I missed it. That's right. Jumping's allowed, so he lets you do this. Whenever they put, like, gates here, though, I always think they put the wall higher than it actually is. And some modders do that. Oh god. Why I picked that up. Oh, the other one didn't want to enter here. That ended up working in my favor. Actually, you know what? Sorry if you hear anything additional. I think my mic, I knocked my mic too high. Oh. Is there... Might be a secret along this wall. Well, if it's there, I probably have to get a switch for it. Can I jump? Yeah, I can jump off of this. But was that a smart idea? Probably not. Alright. And this is why we save. So there is a way to get out of there without taking too much damage. Yeah, but how do I... See, this is the eternal question. How do I actually leave? Oh, that's it. All right. There we go. And hey! We got old reliable. It's actually a pretty nice secret. Holy god, I still have like half the level to explore. I need to go south though. Back to here. Oh. Nightmare cacodemons. Oh wait, is that Mayan with a hand in front of it? Yeah, honestly, that wasn't one of Twitch's better ideas. I just really have no clue what else to use it for other than, like, the default stuff. That's probably why they put it in beta. And didn't, and didn't make it available to everyone yet. What is that thing? Oh, Jesus. Oh, these guys teleport? Or maybe it was just a stage, I don't know. Maybe they do teleport. Yeah, they do. They teleport on their own. That's not part of the level. Is that him or is that a different one? Oh shit! Oh, I got roasted. Now I'm in shit shape. I knew there was one back here. I think there's teleporters behind those. Now I'm scared. That was, yeah, spiders. Jesus. Wouldn't be so bad if that wasn't really fucking loud.
Holy shit.
Okay, in a small room like this, that really fucking hurts. Well. Christ. I wonder if they can telefrag you. God. Man, he really didn't care about him. Just wanted to make sure there was none on that side. I knew this was here. Oh, hi. That's another one of those rooms. Although it seems like this time around they just spawn it, or they just open. What the hell was that? Oh god! I've seen them before. They were actually in Eviternity. Rocket Barons. Yeah, they are. And they're very, very intimidating. Actually, I think they're called Cyber Barons, if I'm not mistaken. Rocket Barons is just easier to think of. This is the end of the level. Considering how, considering what he threw at me, I did that relatively unscathed. Oh yeah, I need to pick that up. I'm just looking to see if there's any section of the map that I may not have searched. This is kind of a big level. Not sure if I really want to... Yeah, I'm not going to go back. Again, if I end up missing out on the secret level, then I'll just pistol start it. Mist from the teleporter subsides, and you find yourself in the primary complex of Neptune, whatever V-115, whatever V-1 is. Oh, those corporate horrors didn't want you to find it, but why? Given UAC's unique knack for screwing things up, what could they possibly be trying to hide down there? Only one way to find out. Now this track, I think, is from Doom 64. Couldn't have worked out better. Oh. Nice. I almost thought that was a spider mastermind. Jesus Christ. Got me again. Hmm. the solo super shotgunner that was stealthily walking around took away half my health this early into the level. That's nice. That is my luck. I was just not paying attention. So yeah, I'm in terrible shape, and I don't really want to save just yet. I think I'm ever gonna be back here anyway. I might as well just pick that up now. Might still be PlayStation Doom, actually. I don't think Aubrey Hodges used the synthesizers like this in the Doom 64 soundtrack, but I could be wrong. Lucky ass shot. Jesus Christ. Of course, that stupid boner decided he wanted to get in the way and protect his buddies. Hey, I didn't take any damage that time. Deserves a save. Oh yeah, I left shotgun rounds back here. Really? Didn't hit a single one, huh? Yeah, screw that shit. Now just stop being fancy and just take the hit. Oh. Nice. I needed that. How does that sound? Oh, it's them. I wonder if he can teleport in here. He hasn't done it yet. Maybe he can. Nah, he might not be. Yeah, they're trying to get in here. They can't teleport through walls. That I can get two super shotgun blasts point blank on a paint elemental like that. I think I can get that. It's gonna be a little tricky though. I think it's gotta be like down to the T, or down to the wire. Pretty sure you can get that. I don't really think it's even worth it. I killed almost everything in here anyway. That's kind of cool, actually. Again, for the most part, it feels like just the regular... Like, for the most part, I think he concentrated more on just level design rather than making an area... Rather than making it feel like, you know, like a facility or things like that. But in here, it kind of makes it... Kind of makes up for that. It's not exactly an easy task making it a level that's actually fun to play and at the same time making it look like it's a feasible, like it would actually be a scientific facility, not just labyrinthian level design. Don't need that. I didn't expect that. Or that. The yellow key. Shut down one of six error screens, huh? Alright, now I gotta look in this room. No, there's none in this room. Yeah, now I gotta keep my eye on finding those. Yeah, I know those things are supposed to act as checkpoints. But I'd still rather use my method of saving. That's why I left that there. That's right, I got that already. Thank you. This must be the default sound effects for those lady scientists, because I hear them being used in other mods as well. The interesting thing is, I think that's the same sound effect as the nurses from Silent Hill 3. Or no, it's the first Silent Hill, actually. Yeah, it's the first Silent Hill. I guess that's the only sound effect I could get. This was really stupid. Might be a good idea to pick that up. I feel like it's somewhere in here that the switch is. Hold on. Throat's getting a little dry. I've actually been neglecting to drink my water. Yeah, probably. I just kind of wish it was in there. I really need that. Got more health, at least. Three more to go. I still haven't found any other error screens yet. Hi, guys. That was stupid. Was not smart, not a big brain play. Cool. See another. Wait, is that the same? That might be the same one. Hi, guys. Is this open now? Yeah, it is. Oh, that's how I get up there. Okay. I don't have to lower anything. I just have to jump on it. Jumping implies that I actually press the space bar. Maybe I don't do that. Nah, I do. I was just doing it too late. There we are, now I'm in better shape. Jumping in this game, because it's usually restricted, is always like secondary in my head. Still haven't seen any other error screens yet. I think that's another one. Yep. I need four more of them. I'm actually thinking that that's what activates the secret exit. Is finding all of them. Because that seems rather unique. Still only have a yellow key. I'm assuming I go back. Yeah. There we are, red key. Oh. Is this a different chain gun? Eh. I mean, I know it's not, it doesn't originate from Brutal Doom, but this is where I associate it. This is just what I associate it with. But it's the Brutal Doom chain gun. Hi. Thank you. I think one's... No, it said it's the chain gun. So there, it's just two different versions of the same chain gun. It doesn't call... Technically, this is a minigun, I think. Since it fires faster, right? And the game says it's a chain gun, but... not really a chain gun. Oh, wait, never mind. No, it is a minigun. Alright, it does call it the minigun. I was actually kind of hoping you would have hit something there. Hi! Another one is just holding the key. Sucks. Just do it over. I was getting hit with practically every rocket. It's actually a really bad idea to fight him in that room. quite sure if it's a good idea to pick that up yet. I got the blue key, but I don't really want to exit yet. Yeah, I actually really do want to find the rest of those error screens. So I've pretty much explored the entire map. Now it's just a matter of finding them all. I know what they look like, and they turn off when I actually hit them, so I know which ones I've actually gotten. So I just need to go to all of the different areas that have computer screens in them. Look for the white screen with stuff on it. Yeah, it's not in here at all. Right? Yeah, nothing in any of them. Nothing on any of these. Nope. And not from the looks of it. Nope. Are you talking to people on Discord or am I going crazy? Is there anyone that was messaging me? No. You might be hearing, there might be a sound effect that might sound like very similar to like a Discord sound effect. There we are. That's three, I just need three more. Hey, demon. Yep, this is PlayStation Doom and Doom 64 themed, so. Perfect fit. And welcome. Right now I'm just looking for what I'm assuming is all the error screens to lead me to the secret exit. Please let... Nah, one of them's not up there. Good. I really don't want to try and get that one. Doing pretty good. I hope you're doing well. Alright, that one wasn't entirely a white text screen. I need to find two more. Just two more. Oh, please don't do that. Sincerely hope whatever you're going through is dealt with as quickly as painlessly as possible. So yeah, I've been through some shit myself, and I've gotten close to that point. Here we are. One more. Yeah, I wouldn't be in here then. Actually, I only found secrets. There's still like four more left to get. This is probably one of them, though. Oh. Oh, now I get it. Okay. Okay, so that's immediately two secrets that I just found. So there's only two more that I need to get. One of them's probably the exit. Which all I need to find is the last error message. I got that one. Be in there at all. Nah. Nope, ain't talking to anyone. Actually picked that up. They're not in here. At the very beginning of the level. Where is the very beginning of the level? Nah, it's not in here at all. Nothing in there. This might not be a secret, but it's helpful. Got that one. Same one. Now, I didn't notice one in here before, but maybe there is one in here. There is another green armor. Like, not on the walls, but maybe on one of these computer screens? No? Yeah, this last one is probably, like, it was probably literally right in front of me. Yep. I try and do my best to like keep up the chatter. Even if there's no one talking in chat. For anyone that's brand new that is thinking about streaming, just try and do that. Pretty much whatever you're thinking, just say it out loud. And get used to that. There's even partnered streamers where their chat's just really quiet, so they just have to... they just have to keep vocalizing things. At the very least, all people just need to hear is a voice, whether it's, whether it's calming, or whether they just know that there's more going on. God, this last one's so difficult to find. They do have different text on them. Where haven't I checked yet? Is there any area that I'm just overlooking? That I keep missing? I got the one in that top room. There's none in that. Yeah, I've gone up there. There is nothing in here. At all. That was where one of the error screens was. Is this an error screen? That's an error screen. Okay, so what door opened? That's why that one was so hard to find, because that one was unique. Now I have to find the door. And I don't know where the door is. Before we go upstairs. Yeah, it's not in here. Maybe out here? In here? Nope. Wait, maybe it's that one in the top left. Because it was a door that was like half open. So maybe that one fully open now. I gotta go down. I can't go up that way. Gotta go down this way, yeah. Wrong way. Yeah, this way. Yep, I was right. Is that Master Chief's helmet? Omega Labs. Only imagine why the UAC saw fit to hide this place. Is this where the V1 experiments were performed? Yep, this is the secret level. Probably won't be able to beat it because I only have about 15 more minutes. Off to an amazing start. Very, very dark. And this is the track I always recognize. This is the track for the first level of a PlayStation game. It's the one that I almost always hear. I don't know what that opens. It doesn't open that. Thank you. hazmat suit guys? I don't need that. I can't get that mega armor, though. Not doing so hot. I need some health. Really use some health. I don't have a blue key card either. I think I have to jump down here. Yep. That helps. Okay. Not worth it because he took away my entire health pool, which is as low as it is. Honestly, this is still better than the minigun is. Missed that. This is like one of the rare occasions where the minigun actually came in handy. I don't want to get that yet because I think that's a mega sphere. Right? Hold on. No, it's a guard sphere. Okay. I have not seen this yet. I'm assuming this just doubles your defense. Yeah, it looks like it. Rocket zombies? They killed each other again. Fucking hell. Two of them. Oh. I think it is, actually. But, I don't know. The version that I have is episode 1 and 2, and I downloaded it, I think, a few months ago. I think he started this, like, what, in 2015? So I'm not sure if he's ever actually gonna finish it. I could be wrong, though. But yeah, it's, technically episodes 1 and 2. And welcome, Imp Boy. Oh, wait. I think... Yeah, there's a switch up there. That I need to get. Or, not a switch, a door. Oh god, I think I know what they are. Actually, I think they were in the first Threshold of Pain. PlayStation Doom. Was that the one that they, I saw something about it on Doomworld. Or, I'm not sure if that's the thing that you're talking about. I know that there was someone developing, like, their own thing of PlayStation Doom. And they were getting different mappers to help out. I'm not sure if that's the Master Edition or not. But if that got released or something like that, I definitely want to play that. Oh god, Infernals? Well, I don't think they're called Infernals. Whatever they are, they're nasty. Ah, okay. Hasn't been released yet. But it has a lot of maps already, I might still try it out then. Two of them. I am not looking good on health. The full release is now, but public beta 3 has enough content to last a while. Yeah, nice. I think I'll check it out sometime soon. I played, like, what was it, the PlayStation Doom Total Conversion, I think it was just simply called. Mm. played that, like, that was one of the first Doom mods I ever streamed. And, it's no secret, I really kind of prefer the PlayStation Doom aesthetic over the regular... over regular Doom. Hello. What the? Oh. Yep. That happened. I really want to see if there's something over here. I can reload again if it ends up running out, because I'm not going to be able to survive anyway. Nope. Nothing else over here. Oh, man. I actually kind of have to quit. Yeah, we'll save and quit right here. Unfortunately, I have work tonight.